Hello students, welcome to the online tutorial for Vidyabhavan Higher Secondary School. This video is for class 11 botany. In this video I will continue with the chapter that I have started with you, that is plants and minerals nutrition. In my previous video I have given you an idea about what is nutrition, what are nutrients, what are food, types of food. So all this idea I have already given to you. Now in this video we will start with the topic of importance of nutrition. Now, what are the importance of nutrition? We have learned the process of nutrition. We have understood the five steps that are required for nutrition. Now, we will see that why it is required. First point, to growth, repair of tissue, gain energy in order to control different metabolic functions. Without nutrients, without food, we cannot grow, we cannot repair our wounded parts. So these are required. Number two, through nutrition, the potential energy stored in the food is transferred into usable energy. Now by doing or by getting that usable energy, we are doing our metabolic, our physiological functions, our biochemical functions, all are being done by utilizing that energy. Number three is that through nutrition, disease resistance power is increased. Obviously, if you are not eating or if you are not getting the proper nutrition or proper nutrients, the disease may attack you because of those. There are two types of food, na, protective and proximate. Protective principles of food or the nutrients which are obtained from that part of food helps in the disease resistance capacity. Okay. Number four, through nutrition, future food matters are stored in the living body, that is fats. Okay. Fats are being, or our, you can say the excess of our food are stored in the form of fat in our body, so that when there is a scarcity of food, when we are not getting enough food, we will not die. Okay, why? Because the body cells are utilizing those stored food, that is the fat cells, okay, to hydrolyze the fat and to get energy. Understood? So this is the reason, this is the store, this is the future planning of the body. Number five, it plays a special role in the production of heat in animal body to meet that caloric demand of an individual. Now you will ask me that how it is producing heat. When you are eating or when you are having any nutrients or food in our body, then and there the digestion started. It starts to break down the food. Now when the digestion is going on, it is breaking down the food, a huge amount of heat energy is created. That's why after having any kind of food or after having our stomach full, okay, we feel a general amount of heat. Our body gets heated up. Why? Because the digestion has already started. It is producing heat energy. Okay. Next is that, so these are the general thing, and these are the general importances. You have to read three importance of nutrition. That will be enough. Now next topic is that essential elements. Now what is this essential elements or essential nutrients, you can say, or minerals? The nutritional requirement of autotrophs include several inorganic ions. These are obtained by them from their surroundings and are called essential elements. That is, autotrophs means what? The one who can prepare their own food, that is the plants. So their requirement, nutritional requirement, that includes several inorganic ions. Okay, and where they do get these ions from their surrounding. Now these inorganic ions are very much essential for their growth and development. That is why these are termed as the essential elements. Okay, now these essential elements, which are, now essential elements are of two types. Now these essential elements which are required in large amounts are called macro elements. Macro means large. I think I have read it in class 9 also. Macro and micro. So the essential elements which are required in large amount, those are the macro elements. And the essential elements which are required in small amount, those are termed as micro elements. proper functioning of the plant body. Now we will see. Now we will see actually some macro ones. Okay, macro elements. These are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, phosphorus. So what are the functions of it? That we will see. It is there. There is a table in your book that is page number 10.3. First is the carbon. It is the first thing that helps in photosynthesis, helps in fat and protein synthesis, because photosynthesis, the resultant product of photosynthesis is glucose. What is the formula of glucose? C6H12O6. Here carbon is required. So for photosynthesis, that for the production of glucose, carbon is highly essential. Next is on fat and protein synthesis. Carbohydrate, fat, protein, all are made up of carbon. Carbon is an essential component of these things. So in order to make carbohydrate, fat or protein, we do require the carbon. Okay. Next coming, oxygen. All the food matters in the plants are made up of oxygen. Oxygen is essential during aerobic respiration for the oxidation of food. And through the process of oxygen fixation, some of the atmospheric oxygen is incorporated into some inorganic constituent. That means, first of all, oxygen is required for respiration. That is for breaking or digestion of food. Okay, that is, oxygen is required. Now you just think, this carbohydrate, it is having O6. So oxygen is required. So these are the reasons that why oxygen is essential. Number 3, nitrogen. Certain bacteria, blue green, algae, they can utilize the gaseous nitrogen, that is atmospheric nitrogen directly. But they can also transform these nitrogen to nitrate ions. Higher plants cannot utilize the atmospheric nitrogen directly. They can absorb the nitrogen from the soil. So they use this nitrogen which are being fixed by the bacteria, and they use it to produce different types of protein. So nitrogen is an essential component of protein, and that is why it is necessary. Next coming, hydrogen. It is also an essential element. Main component of cytoplasm of the cell is water, which contains hydrogen. Obviously cell is containing water. Apart from this, you think about this carbohydrate also. It is also containing hydrogen, so it is necessary. Next coming, phosphorus. It occurs in nucleic acids, phospholipids, enzymes like NADP, FADP, okay, and energy compounds like ATP, GTP. So for these things, or for the production or manufacturing of these things, phosphorus is highly essential. And phosphorus containing compounds are involved in photosynthesis, and the deficiency symptoms of phosphorus are that stunted growth, leaves turn dark blue green, premature leaf fall. So the plants do require phosphorus. Next coming, sulfur. It is an essential component of protein. Nitrogen as well as sulfur, both are essential component of protein. Enzymes, biotin, coenzyme, sulfur containing compounds takes part in respiration, lipid synthesis, and deficiency symptoms are that the leaves become yellow, that is chlorosis. That disease is very important, chlorosis. We will get to know about this in the latter part of the chapter. Chlorosis, it is a disease affected by the deficiency of sulfur in the plant body. So depigmentation, decoloration, all these things due to the sulfur lacking. Next coming, calcium. Calcium is absorbed from the soil in the form of calcium ions. It plays an important role in plasma membrane organization, mitosis, chromosomal stability. It acts as an activator of many enzymes. It occurs in the, it plays an important role in the formation of the cell wall. And its deficiency symptoms are like that, drying out of meristems, chlorosis in the margin of the young leaves. So these are the deficiency symptoms of calcium. Next coming, magnesium. It is an important part in protein synthesis. It takes place, and after this, the most important function of magnesium is that it is an important part, an important component of chlorophyll. So it is very important, and its deficiency leads to mottled chlorophylls, and the leaves become brittle. So these are the general, the deficiency symptoms. Now coming iron. Iron ओवरऑल प्लेज एन इम्पोर्टेंट रोल इन मेटाबॉलिज्म एंड इट टेक्स प्लेस इन द सिंथेसिस ऑफ क्लोरोफिल एंड रेस्पिरेशन. So all these are the general functions of the iron. Apart from this, there is the potassium. Potassium obviously carbohydrate and protein metabolism or protein synthesis you can say, and it affects the process of respiration, photosynthesis and chlorophyll synthesis. So these are the general functions of the different macro elements. Okay, so till this much I am keeping my today's video. In the next video, I will continue with the chapter. Thank you.